I'm back at Hinkley Point C to find out, this time, more about scaffolding. Okay, so we're back at Hinkley Point C outside of the LB6 building where the outside of the reactor is being built for Unit 1, and I'm with Shannon. Hey, Shannon.
Hi, nice to meet you, Tom.
Okay, now Shannon, what do you do?
So I'm an apprentice scaffolder with Kaefer at the moment. So basically we build structures for people to work off so that they're safe for working at height for whatever access to their needs. But basically my job at the moment is to learn and gather knowledge so that I can pass my qualifications and become fully qualified.
Okay, so your apprenticeships last for how long?
Yeah, so my apprenticeship programme will last roughly 3 years, maybe a bit longer, depending on how quickly I learn things and the knowledge that I gain from experience at the moment. But basically I'm just learning off my team to show me how to do things correctly and the safest way possible to erect something for someone to work off.
Brilliant. And what's it like working here at Hinkley Point C?
Oh, it's massive, it's huge. I've never been on such a big site. It's a huge development and something's different every day, so there's always a new challenge. There's always a new challenge to come up against or something new to learn from someone else or just to see. It's an amazing project.
What are you looking forward to doing after your apprenticeship?
I'm hoping to gain as much knowledge as possible in the industry and stay with Kaefer and hopefully progress as far as I can, to be honest. So yeah, I'm just really hoping to get on well and get my head down and knock along with it.
Now, you said about big and the scale of everything. I can't help but notice this. What on earth is this?
So this is the Novum ring. This is what they'll use to lift the outer core of the reactor there. So the liner for the outside, they'll use that to lift that out of there and then put it on HR1, I believe.
I've noticed that you're wearing a green helmet. What's that about?
So I've got a green helmet because I'm a certified first aider. So if anyone needs anything, any first aid assistance or anything, they can come over and identify me straight away and then I can give them help.
What would you recommend people study if they wanted to get into scaffolding?
I would say you need a good general knowledge of maths, you need a good physical fitness, but you really need to be able to communicate with people to be able to assist and like query anything if you're unsure, because it is just constant communication, anything. Yeah.
We always ask this question, what do you enjoy the most about your job, Shannon?
I love the fact that I work with a team, that I can communicate with people, and there's a new challenge every day. There's something different every day, so you're sort of getting a grasp of what sort of challenges you're going to come up against in the industry itself. So it's nice to learn, it's just such a big scale, so I don't know how to describe it to you. Something's different every day, literally every day.
Brilliant. So it's been wonderful to be with Shannon to learn more about scaffolding. If you do want to find out more information, just click on the links below.